Hi, we're at Mount Muztagh Atta, or Atta Muztagh, on the Pakistan-Chinese border. We've just got dropped off here on a bus in the middle of nowhere, so we're sort of on our own here, and we're gonna try to hike up to base camp and camp overnight. It's looking pretty snowy up there right now. I don't know, it's pretty cold. It's a lot colder than I thought it was gonna be. We're about 3,500 meters right now. Base camp's about 4,500. Hopefully we're gonna camp at base camp at 4,500 and then do a day hike up maybe around to 5,000, 5,500 meters. The mountain's about 7,500 in total. We're a bit out of season right now. It's most people come up here in the summertime and it's not quite summertime yet. And I think we're probably gonna be the only ones up here, but I think it's gonna be great. Thanks. Alright, we're back here at Mount Muztagh Atta on the Chinese-Pakistan border, and we're a little bit lost right now. We've been hiking for 3 or 4 hours and we're looking for base camp. And we don't really know where it is. This sort of stuff will happen when you have a guide or you're just doing climbing mountains by yourself. But now we think base camp might be up here somewhere near this big glacier up there. So we're gonna hike up there and hopefully get up a ridge to advance base camp before we head back down. Hopefully it'll work out. Our next big problem is warmth. We've made it successfully down from base camp alive, so that's a good thing, but tonight we may die. Last night it was about, minus 15 to minus 20. My sleeping bag's rated for plus 5 and I almost froze to death. We're sort of in a barren wasteland here, so there's not any real trees to start a fire. We've got sort of a plan to start up a big fire, put some rocks in it, put the rocks in some socks, put the socks in our sleeping bags, and that should keep us warm all night. I think rocks hold heat really well. But we don't have any firewood. Nothing but rocks and everything. So while we're out hiking today, we filled up a backpack with the odds and ends that we thought we might be able to burn. The first thing we got here is some piece of a dead rabbit, I think, or something. I don't know if it was his leg. There's bone in there. I'm gonna use that to start the fire. That's it. Anyone who's ever lit their hair on fire knows your hair just woof, floats right up. And the only wood we could find was little twigs and sticks and all this little stuff here that sort of grows out of the ground. Nothing that impressive. No good trees there. So we went to a local method, which is burning shit. Lots of, they've got camels around here and sheep, and they've been up here. They take them up here in the summertime. So we've collected a whole whack of dried shit to burn tonight. So hopefully it's gonna work. This is the stuff I haven't graded yet. Now this stuff here, you see, this stuff's not that good because it's kind of wet on the inside. A little bit wet, it's not gonna burn that good. So I put that in the wet, half dry wet pile, put that on after the fire's already cooking. Now this pile, this is what you want to see right here. This is a nice camel turd, I think. Now that is nice, nice and thin. It's been dried all the way through. So I think that stuff's gonna burn pretty good. We had all this stuff during the day, but this really wasn't still gonna be enough to start a fire until I found the piece de resistance. This lovely wooden box in the middle of nowhere that I've liberated from some sort of communist facility. I don't know how, but it was just sitting there. I only wanted to break a couple things to get it loose, but This is our puppy. She's all dry and it's gonna heat our rocks up that we're gonna put in the socks. Remember that we're gonna put in our sleeping bags so that we won't die and we'll end up being two happy boys. Doodly doo.
Oh yeah. Oh, we tried that. I was going on earlier, but we're gonna put hot rocks in our socks. Don't listen to me, kids. Don't try this at home. I put a hot rock in a sock, and the sock basically lit on fire. So we've had to revise our hot rock strategy. Right now we put a big cold rock, big flat cold rock in the tent, and we put some hot rocks on top of that rock. And we also have some hot rocks inside of a pot. So, yeah, I think it's going to warm up the tent a little bit. We're mostly just killing time, seeing how late we can stay up, how long our wood's going to last, so we don't have to stay in the tent very long. We can just get up and go home. But we got the shit on the fire right now. It's going pretty good. It's a slow burning shit. I think our shit is a little bit wet. It could have been cured better. But the box is burning fabulously.
Yeah.
Thank you, communist installation.
That's all we got left.